गुड आफ्टरनून नाना, ऑल ऑफ यू, कैन यू हियर मी? आकाश, वाई द स्ट्रेंथ इज ओनली 15? व्हाट वाज द स्ट्रेंथ इन द मॉर्निंग?
मैम, इट वाज अराउंड 40 मैम, इन ओएस क्लास.
ओके. Morning, DM class was not there.
It was combined class, ma'am.
Okay. Who took it?
DM, Spandana, ma'am.
Okay. You were batched with along with whom? Which section?
Combined? E section, ma'am. E section. Okay.
So then, the approximately what was the strength?
It was around 80, ma'am. Morning class.
Okay.
In DM.
Okay. So we'll just wait for 2 till 2:05 and then start.
Okay.
Yeah. Shall I start, Nana, see us the class, or shall I wait still? Only 28 are there. Will they be joining, or shall I start with the class? So in the last class, we have started with the concept of classification of cost, isn't it? What are the various classifications of cost which are classified into 15 is what we said. So out of which long run versus short run, so based on the period, and long run refer to all cost here becomes fixed or variable in long run. Can anyone answer? In long run, all cost become fixed or variable?
Variable.
Yeah, in short run?
Fixed,
isn't it? Except what would become variable in short run?
Except labor.
Yeah, except labor. To an extent, we can increase labor, but other factors becomes fixed as the period is only 3 months to 1 year. Then the next important concept here is semi-fixed versus semi-variable. And here, to an extent, it might be fixed and later it would be variable. Or to an extent, it would be variable and later it would be fixed. So this is about semi-fixed versus semi-variable. Then the fourth one is marginal cost. Marginal cost refer to extra one unit. Cost incurred to manufacture extra one unit. And we have even talked about various marginal concepts such as marginal revenue, marginal production, and marginal cost. So marginal revenue is nothing but revenue derived out of selling extra one unit. Marginal production is production derived out of adding extra one unit. Okay. So this is about marginal cost. And did we cover controllable versus non-controllable?
Yes, ma'am. Up to controllable cost versus non-controllable cost, yes, we covered.
Yes, we have covered. So here, controllable cost is like which can be controlled in the hands of the manager or the production manager or the manager is known as controllable, and such as R&D, research and development, advertisement expenditures, salary of executives, executive directors, which can be controlled. And in the year of higher profits, maximum amount can be invested in such area, and in the year of lower profits, such can be controlled. And non-controllable cost where you can't run the production process is example fixed cost and variable cost. Fixed cost such as rent, insurance, and salary of administration officer and so on. Variable cost such as cost incurred in raw material, cost incurred in labor cannot be controlled. If you control those, your production becomes hot. So this is all about the controllable versus non-controllable. Akash and Janavi, just have a look who have been joined from now. Okay. Just write down their numbers now.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. So this is about controllable and non-controllable costs. Now coming to the opportunity cost versus outlay cost. So just listen carefully. This is one of the important concepts where we normally use in our day-to-day life or even in the business decisions or even in the case of routine, like how we take the decisions in the area of cost. So what do you mean by opportunity cost is next best alternative foregone is known as opportunity cost. Here, it's nothing but each and every decision or each and every problem have multiple alternatives, isn't it? Like, for example, you have a certain amount in your hand. So how best you utilize that amount in your perception would be the decision that you take. So the priority wise, the first decision is what you opt for. The first option you would opt for is the decision you normally take, the actual cost that you take. The second best alternative or the second best option that you have foregone is known as opportunity cost. Always remember the next best alternative foregone, because the resources are limited. Like you have only certain amount, like 25,000 is what the amount that you have. You have a limited resources of amount of money. You have multiple options. So multiple options such as investing in a piece of plot or purchasing a plot is known as the first option. The second option would be just keeping in a bank as an FD where you get in return the interest, or any other option that you prefer, or giving a hand loan or whatever, because the rate of interest is more rather than even you have a risk factor where the interest is high. So the first option that you have gone for is you have purchased a piece of plot as there is a good real estate scenario going on in our place. So then what we do, we select the first option. The second option is investing, putting in a bank in FD So this is known as opportunity cost. It's not only the safety that you look, but also the interest that you foregone, but not, by not doing an FD is known as opportunity cost. Or we can give your own example of selecting your BTech course. Once you finish off your intermediate, you have n number of options. Either you can take up a BTech course, or either you can take up a full-time job, or either you go for a degree graduation course, or whatever. So, but you have opted for BTech. So what is an opportunity cost for it by not taking up a full-time job? So the opportunity cost for your BTech course is not only the fee, the books and the salary, the books and the thing that you pay for your BTech, but also the salary by not taking up a full-time job. Okay, so this is known as opportunity cost. Or even you can take a farmer. A farmer opts to sow wheat as an cultivation for his farming. So he may have n number of options. Wheat is what the first, the second might be. So depending upon the land and the climatic and natural situations, he may opt for wheat. But there are another options such as maize, rice, barley, like that. There are many other options that he has. So the second option may be rice. So it's nothing but the opportunity cost of that particular land of farming is by not sowing rice. So this is known as opportunity cost. So once you have a priority list, the second best alternative foregone by not opting it is known as opportunity cost. Now, what is outlay cost? Outlay cost is a real cost that you have paid out of your pocket, is known as outlay cost. So, sixth one is opportunity cost versus outlay cost. Any doubts in this opportunity cost? Yes, Nana, any doubts?
No, ma'am.
Opportunity cost is nothing but the second best alternative foregone is known as opportunity cost. So this is the two examples that we can give. When you have an amount of 25,000, how you invest and what is the opportunity cost for it. Or opting for a BTech course, it's not only the fee and the book cost, but also the salary that you have foregone by not opting the second option of full-time job. So this is known as opportunity cost versus outlay cost. Now going to the incremental cost versus sunk cost, S-U-N-K, sunk cost. Are you writing in your books, all of you, the side headings? I'm just asking you to write the side headings along with the example so that you can remember once you see what are the different types of classifications of cost. Please make sure that every running notes are there in your book. Don't expect me to check your running notes. So are you taking it down, the side headings, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So now going to the, so are you taking down the students who are joining now?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, I took screenshot those who, when you said.
Yeah.
Again, I will take the screenshot so that I can.
Nana, you can't see that, like even your screen will also be the same, isn't it?
No, ma'am, we can't identify who are joining.
Yeah. Ma'am, I've noted down few roll numbers, ma'am. I did see.
You just now have joined.
Yes, ma'am, I noticed that. I've sent
it
just to...
Today, okay. I just want to take it seriously because it's a high time for us to take a call. Like one class, two class, three class, we have done with the two units. Is a third unit and it's time for me to take a call as what is the reason of the absentees and the students who are joining late. So today, for sure, I'll take each and every call for the students who have joined late and the absentees, okay? So please make sure that I want the absentees as well as the latecomers. Is it fine, Nana? All CRs, Janavi, yes, and Akash, yeah.
Yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am.
So now, so this is what incremental cost versus sunk cost, the seventh classification of cost. So seventh classification of incremental cost is nothing but cost incurred because to increase the production is known as incremental cost. Sunk cost is already incurred, but no benefit derived out of such cost is known as sunk cost. So I'll give you the examples as what do you mean by incremental cost and what do you mean by sunk cost. Incremental cost is the cost incurred due to increase in production. So if we want to increase our production, what all costs would be increased, such as cost of labor, cost of raw material, cost of technology, machinery, and so on. So such cost of increase in production is known as incremental cost. And increase in cost due to increase in production is known as incremental cost. And what do you mean by sunk cost? Sunk cost is already incurred, but no benefit derived out of it. So let me give an example which you can better understand. So like, for example, I require a new machine which cost me 1 lakh. For my production, there's a new machine that have been innovated. So I want to purchase where it cost me 1 lakh. So what I have done, I have ordered it. I have ordered it to a particular company by making a down payment of 10,000. Okay. Hello. 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 So by making a down payment of 10,000, I have I prefer to purchase from one particular company. But later on inquiry, I found out that the same machine is available for 70,000 outside. So I go and prefer to buy it 70,000, which some other company would procure me at 70,000. Hello. Hello. So what I do is I purchase the machine for 70,000 outside. So whatever the 10,000 that I have paid for first company, that is mere waste, isn't it? I didn't get any benefit out of it because I didn't purchase the machine at all. So such cost is known as sunk cost. Is it clear, Nana? Cost already incurred, but no benefit derived out of such cost is known as sunk cost. Example, the 10,000 that I have paid as a down payment to purchase from first seller of a machine, but later I found out that it is available only for 70,000. So I have purchased from the second seller. So whatever I have paid 10,000 from the first seller is a mere waste. Such cost is known as sunk cost. Okay. Now going on to the next one, explicit cost versus implicit cost. So this is the 8th classification. Explicit cost is nothing but out-of-pocket cost or the real cost that have incurred or that have been paid for payment of rent, payment of interest, payment of salary, and so on. Such cost is known as explicit cost. Implicit cost refer to would have been incurred but not incurred. Okay, which would have been incurred but not incurred, such as salary of the proprietor or the owner, or interest on own capital, rent of own building. Such cost is known as implicit cost. The cost would have been incurred but not incurred. If we would have taken a premises for rent, we would have paid rent. But that's own building of the proprietor, so therefore he need not pay rent. Such cost is known as implicit cost. If you would have been the capital outside, either you would have paid interest or either you have paid dividend or either you have paid interest on debenture. But if you start the business with your own capital, you will not take interest, isn't it? So the profits that you enjoy is the benefit derived out of it. So interest on own capital, rent on own building, salary of the proprietor, these are all the examples of implicit cost. Is that clear? Explicit cost is a real outflow of cash, such as payment of salary, payment of rent, payment of interest, payment of insurance, and so on are the examples of explicit cost. So implicit cost versus explicit cost is the 8th classification. Are you following, Nana? What do you mean by opportunity cost versus outlay? Incremental cost versus sunk cost? Explicit cost versus implicit cost? Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now going to out-of-pocket cost versus book cost. Out-of-pocket cost is the same explicit cost which really incurred, where the cash outflow do happen. There is a cash outflow from the business is known as out of pocket cost. Book cost is nothing but depreciation. We'd be charged but not actually incurred. Depreciation, can anyone describe or define what do you mean by depreciation in business? If we remove depreciation from GDP, we get GNP, isn't it? So what do you mean by depreciation? And what do you mean by depreciation in the business? What do you mean by depreciation? You have never heard in economics?
Decrease in value of something, ma'am, like an asset or a property.
Very
good. For the country, because it could be because of the stock, Sensex, or the current value of the currency.
Yeah. So here, in the case of business, depletion in the value of the asset is known as depreciation. As I said, once you bring a car, new brand new car from out of the showroom, use it for 3 months and want to sell it, will you get the same amount? No, isn't it? The difference of amount is known as depreciation. It's nothing but decrease in the value due to normal wear and tear or due to normal usage is known as depreciation. So here, depreciation would be only shown in the books of accounts, but not really incurred, isn't it? Like even if we purchase a furniture, the value of the furniture and the next year would not be same. It would be decreased, isn't it? So the difference of amount is known as depreciation, which would have not been really incurred, but we record it. So a cost that would be recorded is known as book cost. That real cost that have been incurred and paid out of pocket is known as out of pocket cost. So can write the example for out of pocket cost is again payment of rent, insurance, salary, and so on. Book cost, example, depreciation. Goodwill. Goodwill will also be valued. What do you mean by goodwill? Goodwill is other example of book cost, which is not really incurred or which is not really paid. It's nothing but value of business is known as goodwill. So goodwill is also recorded in the books of accounts, that is known as book cost. So what is the literal meaning that you know about goodwill? Goodwill is valued in the business, isn't it? So what do you know about it? What you know about the goodwill, Nana? Goodwill? Did you ever heard about it in the business? So normally, once we purchase a business, once we take over a business, the seller of the business charges the goodwill. Goodwill is nothing but the popularity or knownness that he has acquired over a period of time is known as goodwill. And goodwill would be valued. Goodwill would not be charged as a cost, but it would be valued. So example of book cost is depreciation and goodwill. Now going to the 10th classification, replacement cost versus historical cost. All of you write down replacement cost versus historical cost. Replacement cost versus historical cost. So what do you mean by replacement cost? So here, each and every company maintain books of accounts in the case of assets and the other products that they use in the business would be valued either a replacement cost or historical cost. Replacement cost is nothing but what is the cost of that particular asset if you want to replace it with a new one. Like it may be a machinery or it may be a furniture or it may be human resources, that is a manager. Like for example, if I want to replace a particular production manager having so much of qualification, having so much of technical skill and experience, what do I get? I cost if I replace that particular manager, that is known as replacement cost. Or what is the cost that I incur if you want to replace an existing particular machine? is known as replacement cost. Now, what is historical cost? Historical cost is nothing but cost incurred at the time of acquisition of the asset is known as historical cost. Like, for example, I incurred 1 lakh to purchase a machinery. So I value that as 1 lakh because at the time of the purchase, my cost was 1 lakh. So such method of valuing is known as historical cost. But most of the companies go for replacement cost. Why? Because replacement cost helps us to identify the market value and what does the company's costs to replace a particular machinery or an asset or whatever. So, because historical cost means there would be fall in the value of rupee and whatever we have purchased for 1 lakh last year, we cannot get it for same 1 lakh now. So, what do the companies do? They normally go for replacement cost because which follow the current trend of market prices and tell us the exact replacement price rather than historical cost. Is that clear? So, this is known as replacement cost versus historical cost. Is that clear? Clear, Nana? Any doubts?
Clear.
Yeah. Now, going to the next one, past cost versus future cost. So, what do you mean by past cost? Past cost is which has already incurred, nothing can be done, or which cannot be controlled, which have been already incurred, is known as past cost. Future cost is a cost which would be incurred in the future, which can be controlled and monitored, which can be minimized. Such cost is known as future cost. Then going to the separable cost versus joint cost. So what do you mean by separable? Separable versus refer to which can be identified based on per unit or which can be identified based on directly is known as separable cost, such as cost of raw material, cost of labor, and so on. But coming to joint cost, which cannot be separated, which will be paid jointly, such as administration officer salary, rent, insurance, telephone bill, power bill, and so on are the examples of joint cost, which cannot be identified based on per unit. Whatever we manufacture based on per unit is not possible in the case of joint cost. But where it is possible is known as separable cost. Such as what is the cost of raw material to manufacture one product? What is the cost of labor to manufacture one product is known as separable cost. Separable versus joint cost. Okay. Going to the 13th point, that is urgent cost versus postponable cost. So here we can classify the cost based on its urgency. Based on its urgency, we can identify various costs such as, for example, whitewashing of a building. So whitewashing of the building of a factory is normally, we say it as which can be postponed. It's not a cost which do have impact on production. Does the whitewashing have impact on production? Whitewashing of the building does have any impact on production? It's a question, and are you there in the class, all of you?
Maybe working environment improves.
So you're talking in that perspective. I'm talking about purely, does it have impact on productivity of a product?
No,
isn't it? So here it can be postponed. But on the same time, like if we have an inauguration of a unit, which is jointly introduced for the first time beside, and we call a dignitary or we call a person to inaugurate. In such situation, is whitewashing compulsory?
Yes, ma'am, for building the brand value.
Yeah, like we bring some dignitary to inaugurate a new division. So in such situation, whitewashing definitely becomes an urgent cost. So depending upon the situation, we need to decide whether is the cost urgent or can it be postponable. So postponable refer to can it be postponed to an extent of period of time where in the year of higher profits we can go for it, and in the year of lower profits we can postpone it. So such cost is known as postponable cost. Urgent is which cannot be postponed. Now we have I have just missed two more classifications. Just take down in your books, Nana. It's not there in the PPT. Just take down two more classifications, out of which the first one is the 14th one is escapable cost versus unavoidable cost. Escapable cost versus unavoidable cost. So here, escapable cost refers to the cost that can be saved by reducing the scale of operations at a lower level. So such is known as escapable cost. And unavoidable costs are again the direct cost, such as cost of labor, cost of raw material and all. If we escape it, we have to even forgo the production. Is that clear? So this is known as escapable versus unavoidable. So which can be partially offsetted to avoid a particular cost is known as escapable cost, and which cannot be avoided is known as unavoidable cost. Okay, so this is known, this is the 14th classification that we have in the case of cost classifications. And the 15th one, the last one, accounting cost versus economic cost. Accounting cost versus economic costs. Accounting cost versus economic cost. So accounting cost is nothing but the cost. How do you arrive at profit, Nana, normally? In the business, how do you arrive at profit? How is profit calculated in the business?
When the selling cost is greater than the production cost.
Yeah, normally what is the formula that we use? TR minus TC, isn't it? In economics, we apply the formula as TR. What do you mean by TR? Total revenue. And what is TC?
Total capital.
Total capital. What is TC? What is TC, Nana? TR minus TC is profit. So TC is capital, is what someone said.
Total cost.
Yeah. What total cost is equal to
fixed cost plus just variable cost.
Variable cost, isn't it? Who is this? May I know who is this?
Abhinav,
79. Abhinav, good. So here it's not total capital, it's total cost. And here, how do we calculate the profit in accounting is to TR minus TC. TR is nothing but the revenue that we get, the amount that we get into the business, and TC is the total cost. That is total cost referred to fixed cost plus variable cost. So difference of these both is profit. That is known as accounting. Accounting cost. Economic cost is a cost that we try to identify what is the present value of future profits. That is known as economic cost. Is that clear? What is the present value of future profits to exaggerate what would be the actual profits at the end of 5 years or end of 3 years? We take the help of time value of money, capital budgeting. So such is known as economic cost, which is not considered in accounting. Okay, so this is what the 15th classification that we say. What is it? Accounting cost versus economic cost. Accounting cost is a normal total cost. Economic cost is nothing but time value of money, that is present value of future profits, would be considered in economic cost, which is not considered in accounting. What we do, we normally calculate the total revenue, we normally calculate the total cost to identify profit. But in economics, we apply various concepts to identify the present value of future profits. So that is known as economic cost. So how many did we done with the classifications of cost? Classification of cost. How many?
15.
15, isn't it? So this is what we, you may get a question. In cost analysis, we have two, Nana. One is, what do you mean by define cost and types of costs or classification of costs? The second one is cost and output relationship in long run and short run. That is the two expected questions in cost analysis, the second main topic in unit 3. Is it clear? Any doubts in cost classifications or types of costs? Any example that you require out of 15? Is every point clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now going to the next one, cost and output relationship in short run and long run. So first we are considering the concept of short run. So what is a short run? A period of short run is equal to? What is the period of short run?
3 months to 1 year.
3 months. Yeah, 3 months to 1 year. So here, this is monthly output is what the first column. Can you see a table?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So the first column is monthly output in units. The second column is total fixed cost. So if you observe, total fixed cost doesn't change. Now, can you give me the example of fixed cost, Nana? Which wouldn't change?
Rent, insurance, rent. Salary.
Yeah, salary of whom? Of all the employees. Okay. Yeah. So this is total fixed cost. So 7 units manufactured chesna gani, our fixed cost doesn't change. It's same as 100. So total variable cost is increasing. Example of variable cost?
Raw material, labor.
Very good. Takman ochali. Example of variable cost under raw material, labor. Raw material is the raw material that we use to manufacture the main product. Labor is nothing but the labor cost that we pay to the labor in the form of wages, either daily, either piece wage or either hourly base, isn't it? So that is known as labor cost. So evenly increases with the increase in production, decreases with the decrease in production. So this is known as total variable cost. Now coming to the TC, TC is TFC plus TVC. And a variable cost plus fixed cost is TC, total cost. So even that is increasing with increase in production. Now average AFC, average variable cost is reducing. How do you get average variable cost? It's nothing but column 2 divided by column 1. Are you following, Nana, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Column 2 is total fixed cost. Column 1 is output. So total fixed cost divided by monthly output, we get average fixed cost. So if you observe, average fixed cost is reducing. Why? Because how many units we manufacture or we increase the production, those many units will share the total cost. So therefore, per unit average fixed cost would be reducing. If you go for 8, it will still reduce. If you go for 9, it will still reduce. So as many you increase your production, your total fixed cost will, average fixed cost would be reducing and reducing. But the remaining all would be increasing. Average variable cost increases. Average total cost increases. Marginal cost will also increase. What is marginal cost? What is marginal cost?
Cost for extra 1 unit.
Yeah, cost incurred to manufacture extra 1 unit. So if you observe here, the last column, how did you get? Always we keep the first column as nil. the second column 130 minus 100 marginal cost is 30 ante okka unit manufacture cheyadaniki marginal cost entha 30 the next is the total cost I'm talking about the difference in total cost now when you manufacture the second unit your marginal cost is the difference between 154 minus 130 is it clear nana tarvata third unit manufacture chesinappudu the difference is 172 minus 154 is 22 so like that cost incurred for extra one unit manufacture extra one unit is known as total cost marginal cost so this is even marginal cost will also increase so except which cost everything is increasing with the increase in production
fixed cost
yeah average fixed cost tappite anni kuda increasing with the increase in production this happens in the short run this is what we say short run out production output cost and output relationship in short run you have to explain all right from total fixed cost what happens to total fixed cost what happens to total variable cost what happens to total cost then average what happens to average fixed cost what happens to average variable cost what happens to average total cost and marginal cost ila how many points you'll get 7 points you need to write in cost and output relationship in short run cost and output relationship in short run you'll get 7 points all increases first average fixed cost doesn't change total fixed cost doesn't change average fixed cost keeps on reducing with your every increase in production so this is how you have to write okay you have to write all the 7 points of our total fixed cost total variable cost total cost tarvata average fixed cost so if you observe see how except this everything is increasing with the increase in production marginal cost increase avutundi average variable cost increase avutundi average total cost kuda increase avutundi is it clear nana so you have to write 7 points as cost and output relationship in short run this is what you need not write the table but just explain the table is shown for you to just practically show how what is the behavior of cost in short run any doubts in this nana any doubts in this you have to draw this diagram average fixed cost is decreasing with increase in production marginal cost is increasing average variable cost decreasing average total cost kuda u shape ante the addition of avc and at tfc and tvc is atc total fixed cost plus total variable cost is total cost so this is what you have to draw and explain all the 7 points what are 7 points first is fixed cost stable with the production variable cost increasing with production total cost increasing with the production average fixed cost reducing with every increase in production average variable cost increasing average total cost increasing marginal cost is also increasing so this is what we say it as cost and output relationship in long run in short run long run entante we superimpose four short run average cost curves on a big long run average cost curve so this is long run output cost and output relationship in long run okay again I'll explain this tomorrow with the long run how it happens and the small concept that is optimum size of the firm this will do it in the next class I have a quiz for you in the cost concept what we have done today okay shall I start the quiz did you follow till short run all of you
yes ma'am
yeah so that's what the responsibility of the CRs to just say remaining not at all bothered huh?